What are hammerhead flatworms?
It looks exactly like it sounds. It is a flatworm with a hammerhead-shaped head. So if you think of a hammerhead shark, put that head on a worm, and that's exactly what it looks like.
And in a lot of ways, hammerhead flatworms are more of a threat than their sharky counterparts.
So the hammerhead flatworm is an invasive species that is a predator of earthworms. And even though it's also a worm, people think, what's the difference between them? And really, it's that one eats the other. So that's where we're more concerned about it.
As any elementary school science student can tell you, regular old earthworms are good for the soil. So the enemy of our friend is our enemy.
It causes ecological harm. It harms our environment by killing earthworms, which can cause money problems because our crops, our gardens, our forests, they depend on earthworms to survive. They do not cycle soil to provide more nutrients. If anything, they're removing the nutrients from the soil by eliminating earthworms.
And flatworms are well designed to be very, very annoying.
It's flat, so that means that it can squeeze into places. It doesn't have a thick cuticle or skin like we see earthworms having. So it's really, really problematic because it can squeeze into anywhere. It can live where the earthworms live and feed off of them.
The little jerks can also defend themselves.
They secrete chemicals that make animals sick. That's their defense mechanism. They're trying not to get eaten. So those chemicals can make chickens sick, dogs, cats.
And if your dog eats a flatworm?
It just makes your dog throw up. And then the flatworm does survive afterwards. I had vet clinics calling and reporting that, yes, we had a dog, it was sick, and the flatworm was alive when the dog threw it up.
So how do you know if you have hammerhead flatworms?
They can be anywhere from 4 inches to 18 inches long. They look like a snake. They're very long and skinny, and people will often mistake them for a baby snake, and then you see that hammerhead. And so they can have striping on them or even like a collar around their neck, if you will. They're pretty obvious when you see the head.
If you've got hammerhead flatworms, you have to be careful how you get rid of them.
So you definitely don't cut it up. Don't cut it into pieces. That tends to be a lot of people's reactions, but being a flatworm, that means it can grow. It doesn't need a mate to reproduce. So if you cut it into pieces, it'll become more flatworms in just a couple of days. You can squish it if you want to. I think that's a little gross, but as long as you're getting the whole flatworm, you gotta make sure you get the whole flatworm.
So what should you do?
I recommend putting it in a container. It could be a resealable container that you can put as many flatworms as you want. It could be a Ziploc bag with just a little bit of salt, but you put that whole flatworm in there, you seal it, and then when you're ready, you throw it away. That way it's euthanizing, the flatworm is gone, it can't crawl out, because remember they can squeeze out of really small places. So if you just throw it out, it'll climb out, it'll go on and live about its life. So this way you're ensuring it is not going anywhere and it can't eat any more earthworms.
And to borrow a line from Smokey the Bear, only you can get rid of hammerhead flatworms.
So it really does come down to anybody, any human finding it and removing it from the environment. We think that they traveled in potted plants and importing and exporting of plants. So since we've helped them spread, it's up to us to remove them now. If we just do nothing, they're just going to stay there, multiply, and eat earthworms.
This is Inside Edition Digital.